الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين استفى ما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنه على خلق عظيم سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم الله سبحانه وتعالى in the Quran al-Kareem has described Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam as having khuluqun azim, that he has the most noble, the most perfect, the most great of characteristics. The greatest adam, the greatest akhlaq, the greatest sifat, the greatest characteristics. In the current situation, it befits us to wonder, why is it that the whole world does not recognize and understand and acknowledge and attest and submit to that khuluqun azim? And the major reason for that is that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the last and final prophet and messenger. His adab and akhlaq form part of his entire sunnah that he left behind as a legacy, as a wiratha to his ummah. Now, the only way any human being will ever discover any aspect of the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, including ever discover any aspect of him being on khuluqun azim, is through the ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There is nobody who can eyewitness that khuluqun azim. A person will either look at it in the texts and the books of the ummah, so you can find that khuluqun azim in the books of hadith, in the books of seerah, in the books of shama'il, or a person is going to witness that khuluqun azim in the individual members, followers of the Prophet ﷺ, the Muslims of this ummah. As far as the textual tradition goes, alhamdulillah, the muhaddithin spent a great deal of effort, centuries of hard and dedicated labor and sincerity to preserve the teachings, the ta'limat of those khuluqun azim on paper. And you will find an absolutely impeccable, complete, perfect record. And you will find even such beautiful portrayals and descriptions that you will feel that the khuluqun azim are just lifting up from the paper and parchment into your eyes and into your heart. But no non-Muslim would ever engage the Muslim textual tradition, naturally, because it's not their deen, it's not their text, it's not their hadith, it's not their tradition. So for the non-Muslim to be able to discover the khuluqun azim, they could only do that by looking for that in the Muslim ummah. And that is the biggest tragedy. And this is not liberal modernist apologetics. Sometimes they may say things that are correct. Sometimes they say things that are correct, and you should not just look at the speaker just because a liberal, modernist, reformist, apologist for Islam may on these days be stressing the fact that the Muslim Ummah does not have that khuluqun azim does not mean they're incorrect or the statement is incorrect because of the person who is saying it. In fact, the statement is 110,000% and we have more right to say it than they do. You see, the right to critique and correct belongs to the person who knows. The professor can critique and correct your paper and exam. The average person can't be allowed to do that. If the average person happens to pick up your paper and point out some flaws, just because they're an average person, you won't say that they're wrong, but you would say that it would have been better and more appropriate if my professor had pointed out these flaws. The flaws are there, that's a factual reality. You have another problem in Pakistan, is even the people who are religious, they have a lot of jazbat. You know, several ulama, surprisingly, even ulama I've not heard from in a few years, have been calling me in the past week. Ke aap to university ke nojawanon ko padhate hain, unke jazbat ka hum kya karne chahiye? Hame itne phone aa rahe hain university ke ladkon se. that should we do this, should we do that. I have gotten a small number. Alum's kids are otherwise busy in other issues, or these days busy in their exams. I have a handful of queries from alum students, actually. I did not break the hearts of those ulama and tell them actually. I let them think that hundreds of you are in a state of agitation and worry over what is going on. But the reality, I think less than 5 people have actually SMS'd, emailed, personally asked me this question. On campus, I've gotten several people off of campus asking me the question that you know I'm talking about. Actually, I think from what I see is actually very simple. If there's tohine sunnat going on, it's only because you yourself did tohine sunnat. Every single Muslim is a cartoon of the sunnah. Every single Muslim male is a pictorial cartoon of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You control this sketch. You're worried that they're going to put 20,000 sketches on the internet? You got a billion, well, till 500 million, half are women. You have 500 million sketches of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam walking around on this earth. Why are you so concerned about the 20,000 sketches that they're going to put on the internet that are going to go away in a minute? What about the 500 million sketches that aren't going away? If you want, you can try to counter those 20,000 sketches and have 20,000 young men volunteer that may sunnah ka namuna pesh ho karata. How about that? For every European who's going to write a cartoon, draw a cartoon, how about one Pakistani young man says, may khud namuna bankar dunya ko dikhata ki sunnat kya hai? That's a response. You don't need to have jazbaat and get all upset. One of the 5 kids, alums asked me, are they wajib al-qatl? Aapne kisko qatl karna hai? Aap kis khet ki gajar mool hai ki aapne jaakar kisi ko qatl karna hai? Allahu Akbar Kabira. Not that he was asking it necessarily that he wanted to do it. Maybe he had heard people saying that. Wo kaun sa kamal hai? Ki aap jaakar unke khilaaf qatl ka fatwa laga dein. That's your sunnat. Sabse funny cartoons already exist in the Muslim Ummah. You want to see funny cartoons of the Sunnah? Walk at this campus at midnight. There are much funnier cartoons here. There are award-winning cartoons walking this campus. None of the 20,000 submissions at Facebook would win the award compared to what you've got going on over here. If you want to counter Tawheen Sunnat, you do Tajdeed Sunnat. That can be something. If your heart is truly broken, if your heart is truly hurt as to what you feel is being done to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam's history, his reputation, his adab and akhlaq, so what can you do about it? You can revive the true adab and akhlaq. I can guarantee you 100,000,000,000% that if the Muslim Ummah was firmly established on the sunnah, adab and akhlaq, no European would even want to write a cartoon. Every European would be wondering, how could I become like you? The hackers are hacking, and you can ban Facebook's website. Who's going to ban these things? Where's that ban? Where's the ban on the tawheen sunnah that Muslims are doing? You're so busy hacking and banning that the Tawheen Sunnah the non-Muslims are doing. And what do you think hurts the Prophet some more? Hamesha kisi ko dili takleef apne se hote hain, ghairon se to kya hota hai? Some random whiteys in Denmark want to draw a bomb on the Prophet's head as a cartoon. You think the Prophet is hurt by that? The Prophet is not hurt by that like this much. Yes, some Muslim young men, that hasn't happened yet, but which you, some of you, not you, but all of you, addressing the whole youth, obviously, but you go and you burn tires and break stores in Lahore, what does it have to do with anything? You just make yourself look worse. And then you give them more cartoons. Next cartoon they'll draw is they'll see a picture on TV of a Lahore guy breaking a store in Mall Road. Next cartoon they will draw is the Prophet breaking a store in Paris, and that'll be their cartoon, that'll be their joke. Here, just